Thing you gotta concentrate on is you want your finger to hit right here, not here. You want to be as close as you can get to that fret as possible. But don't be on the fret. Don't be back here.
Yeah.
Right there. You do an A minor, put your finger right there. Not here.
Does that sound like it's in tune?
No.
You know, I found out that I'm tone deaf. I didn't know that.
Use your tuner.
G, just a little bit of a shock there. You can take all day just tune in one screen. Okay. Oh, another thing they had that was good on PBS was it was that Ken Burns Country.
Oh yeah, that was a good show.
Oh man.
It was a great series. Anything by Ken Burns is great.
Yeah. I really like Vince Gill. You know, that's he's great.
And Marty Stewart.
Yeah. Boy, they've been there for a long, long time.
What's the lady that, the black lady that she does a lot of the on-screen stuff?
Offhand, I don't know.
Good attention. She's really good too.
Long time ago, I can't think of his name. He's got a long angular face. I love it. Okay, anyway, he had a background, black background singer, and she was really something, boy. He filled it out.
Once today.
Oh, I've been so lazy. I went down in our apartment complex, they got a bingo. So I went down there and I had just bought cleaning supplies and I bingoed one bunch of cleaning supplies. Oh well. No excuse now. Hey, I'll show you something cool. Oh, you're doing. I heard you do Green Acres there. It sounded like.
I've been fooling around with friends of the books.
That's a great song.
Thank you. drop the finger there. Drop it across.
Oh.
And then raise your fingers up again. So that's second finger. You're just doing a run on this side.
Yeah. Well, did you have them written out for you, or you just figured it out?
I had the book of the music, so I knew the chords.
So far, so good.
Do you have a mate that you play with at home, or do you have somebody that you play around, you know, on the...
You guys.
Oh, that's it? Because yeah. you really practice a lot.
Well, yeah. But you practice at least.
I want to learn how to do
there's
that.
There's a guy, I do subscribe to one service that's like $4 a month. It's a... Subscribe Star. It's kind of like Patreon, but it's cheaper. It's a guy named Ukulele Cheats.
Cheats.
Ukulele Cheats. C-H-E-A-T-S. And he does some amazing stuff.
Well, yeah, there's some stuff out there. I joined Chordify, and I can't figure out how to work it. So my $298 or however much it costs.
Mm-hmm.
I look at computers and it's just like I see nothing.
Okay.
Just a blank sheet.
So what is Chordify?
It's a music processing thing that you pay like $3 for a month.
It's kinda like OnSong or OnSong.
Oh,
it's an online.
I think you can put
maybe some
nearly any song in there and it will pay the chord, right?
Yeah. It's a good program. Maybe the cooler weather forced everybody to stay outside.
Nobody
wants
to.
Well,
come.
It's not
7
yet. Some people
want
to
come crawling in
the
dark.
7
on the dark.
Yeah, we're.
Yeah, they're enjoying hopefully. This cool
99
fall.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, a little. Not
caught. And you got all the jackets out and everything.
But that's better than 100.
Yeah,
the last couple of days have been sort of real rough.
Who's the fourth day of this mountain thing?
Oh, we are, we go out there a lot.
You do a bunch of the star parties?
Oh, yeah, we do the star parties and just that, and then just being at Fort the Davis Mountains campground.
Oh, that park. Place is great.
I mean, it's just the sky is just amazing there. Yeah. So, and then we like that place, and we like Alpine, which is 10-20 miles away. I guess.
Where is Paula?
She's got a cold.
Oh.
Mild cold. Wasn't feeling well, but she.
Just about Paul and Paulette.
Yeah, where's Paul?
I mean, Paul's sound is having trouble tonight.
He's almost always here by 6:30. I mean, yeah, 6:30.
Jerry, pass him that.
Oh, yeah.
Sign that, please.
Yeah.
Has anybody talked to Marty and find out how he's...
Oh, you mean Walter?
I'll be glad to tell you.
Sorry, hey, do I have Alzheimer's? Do I?
Well,
we got a note from him saying he was doing pretty good. Everybody wished him good tidings, you know.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I saw that on
last week.
Yeah. Nice that he was still alive.
We called him from the...
It was good to know that from much
the,
that's right, yeah.
The beer place. We called it the beer place.
left the voicemail on his machine. No, I didn't expect him to answer, but he left the voicemail. So when he got around to it, he could hear it.
Well, he didn't say anything in his email about when he might be coming back. Last time when he did something like this, it was seemed like several weeks before he got back. But then he had some problems, some disabilities.
Complications.
Yeah.
And if you don't want to have that,
just take one of them off.
Yeah.
Well, that was great, Margarita.
Wow. I'll write it for $100.
The original
margaritas are too sweet, but
Texas
martini or Mexican martini. I can't remember what they call it there, but
it's one of these things,
a little bit less sweet.
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure because I have two of a motorcycle,
and I've got a pretty complicated thing I want to try to play tonight, so it may not work.
At least if you give me that, I won't have.
Oh, maybe that's exactly what you need.
Well,
loosen up, don't be nervous about it. It'll be fine. Yeah, I was at a retirement party for a friend. So.
What's a kind of friend?
He's got another job.
Yeah. Wow.
He's leaving that place.
Yeah.
We're going to another place.
Yes, exactly.
It's not too.
But they called it an early retirement because they paid him 6 months of pay to leave now. So it's like,
oh wow.
Right.
There you go.
Yeah.
Hey, what? I hire out.
I'll write it down.
Just give me 6 months of pay and I won't come around.
Just never show up.
Probably cost what? $60
for I'm glad to make that deal with you.
Yeah, sounds sweet, doesn't it?
10 or 12 bucks.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
And I have to write it down.
But it will come with those on it.
Uh-huh.
How's it going, kids?
Yeah.
How you doing? Been a while. Got in 3,800 miles of quality family time. And a couple over a few weeks. And all the way to Breckenridge, up to Mount Rushmore and the Crazy Horse Monument.
Wow.
To northern Minnesota and back down again.
Wow, that's quite
back to the oven. It was
part of northern Minnesota.
My in-laws have a cabin on Leech Lake. It's kind of near Bemidji.
Okay. That I'm familiar with.
But it's about maybe 150 miles south of the Canadian border. Not that much, maybe 100 miles south.
I used to go to the place, I think it's called Pequot Lakes.
Huh.
It's close to there.
So did you get have any problems with the smoke from Canada?
Not while we were there. It was glorious.
West, smoke is further east, wasn't it?
I mean, earlier in the summer, you know, when I was in New York in June, the day before we got there, there was all kinds of smoke. I mean, it was so thick that you couldn't see the entire island of Manhattan. And then the night before we flew there, it kind of blew out.
Wow.
So we had three really nice days while we were there. So can't complain.
Yeah, Bonnie, who was it in Manhattan, sent us some pictures of it. It was pretty amazing. Huh?
Before and after.
Yeah.
Pictures.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Versus not this one.
I believe I see Charlie there. How you doing?
Hello, hello. I'm doing just fine. How are you guys?
Doing okay.
Very good.
Oh, I need to get connected to that speaker.
Good, good. Good to see everybody.
Yeah, here's a sample of the sunset on the
oh,
dock.
Man.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah,
tough duty there to see that.
Pretty picture.
There you go. With my daughter just standing on the end of the dock contemplating life.
Oh, nice.
Is that the microphone
that
picks us all up?
That's the speaker.
Oh,
that's the speaker. It's up there by the camera.
Thank you.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Coming.
Oh, okay, good.
All right.
Well, you're up and about. Very good.
Very slowly.
Yeah.
We're going to need a report.
I'm hobbling along.
All of us that have back pain and sciatica need to know how it went.
Does it? Can it be fixed? Yeah.
I've just got having problems with my hip right now.
Oh, you should have had him put your new one in while you were there.
Oh, yeah.
Good old near new lower end.
Yeah. Redo the chassis.
So, is this your song,
Walter? That's got to be Walter.
That's my song, although I don't think I'm really ready to play it.
Okay.
A little complex for me to do without any practice.
Okay, well, I actually appropriated the song, unfortunately. If it's okay with you, Walter, I'd like to play it this evening. Would that be fine?
That's okay.
Okay. Now, there is a portion of the song that says Walter on it, but you don't have to participate in that portion if you don't wish to.
Well, two different people on Zoom trying to do it. If you wanted me to play my kazoo, I think it would be hard.
Okay. Well, we'll just let that go by the wayside, and some other time you can gift us with a kazoo portion.
Happy to do it.
Yep.
I'm sorry I'm interrupting.
No, that's all right.
You're welcome.
Come sit down.
Well, I have my little dog in the car. He's elderly. Usually, I
come get your dog and sit down.
Yeah, we don't. We like dogs.
We're not anti-dog.
We won't tell anybody.
Okay, he's in a stroller. He's like.
We're down here where they don't see us. So you can do anything you want to do.
You can get in that door right there. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Sure.
Maybe you'll want to sing along.
Oh, you know, my daughter-in-law has a Corgi Australian Shepherd mix that has the best yodel of anybody. He's just really loud. Right. Okay. Okay, are we, should we go ahead or should we wait for a moment?
Go ahead.
Okay, here we go. Oh, me, oh, my, oh, whatever shall I do? Confession is peculiar. I'd give a lot of fun if only I could know. The answer to my question, is it yes or is it no? Does your Judas favor out of it? Let this go out. If your mother said, don't you? He said, it's all it out of spite. Can you catch him on your tonsils? Can you even love them right? Does your Judas favor out of it? Let's go overnight. Here comes the clutching part, the worm is by her side. Up to the altar, as steady as Gibraltar. Why, the worm has got the ring, and it's such a pretty thing. But as he slips it on her finger, the choir begins to sing. Does your Judas favor on the fifth time? If your mother said, don't you eat, do you swallow out of spite? Can you catch in on your tonsils? Can you even left and right? Does your Judas favor on the fifth overnight? Now the nation flies as one to send their honored sons up to the White House. Yes, the nation's only White House to voice their discontent unto the president, to ask the burning question, what has swept this continent? Does your Judas favor on the bedpost overnight? If your mother says, don't you, be swallowed out of spite. Can you get cheat on your tonsils? Can you even let them right? Does your Judas favor on the bedpost overnight? On the bedpost overnight. Short and sweet.
Very nice.
You know that song? Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
It is a burning question.
That's got to be a ragtime. Walter probably knows. Walter, what's the history of that song?
It's from the British Music Hall. And it became a hit again in the 1950s when it was revived for a short time and got the whole country of Britain in a thing called skiffle, if you've ever heard of that. There were thousands of young people playing skiffle. And there's always a thing about the T-chest bass. And I've never heard of it or seen a T-chest bass. Maybe some of you know what it is.
I thought it was one of those, it was like an upside down wash tub, and they tied a cord between that and the broomstick, and you moved the broomstick back.
That's what I figured.
They also had an instrument that was like a hi-hat cymbal on a stick that you bounced the stick up and down, and then you had a box on there as well that you'd play with the drumstick. You get rhythm and cymbals crashing and stuff like that too. I don't know what the name of the instrument was, but it was, if you look at like Mary Poppins, the movie, that band that sings with in the cartoon scene with Dick Van Dyke, they have one of those instruments going.
And the great piece of trivia about skiffle is that that's how the Beatles started. They started a skiffle band in the 50s in Liverpool.
And the rest is history.
Do not adjust your sets at home.
If I didn't see that. What's the function of the
Well, yeah,
they wouldn't have known.
Okay, okay.
All right. That's for, yeah, that's for Hancock.
Yeah, for Hancock.
Right.
The more people that we have, the better off we get to keep this place.
Give us a bigger discount.
Yeah. We go from free to 10% below free.
You know, when we looked around, Paulette and I did, just to try to fill out a couple of different places, the recreation center that's on Allendale, what is it? Yeah, that road changes so many times. Just east of Mopac.
Candy?
Yeah.
The Northwest.
2222.
Northwest Rec Center?
That's it, yeah. We went by there. And it was interesting. They weren't as friendly as they are here. Plus, it was, you got 1 hour, something like 1 hour once a month free.
Wow.
And then it was $125 an hour
wow.
to rent the
Ooh.
Place. And it's like, wait a minute.
Well, thanks for looking into it.
Yeah.
Think we'll stay put.
Thanks for confirming this choice.
Yeah. As long as we're on that subject, I've been thinking the Unitarian Church might be a good place to do it. And I'm a member, but as a member, I can get a room for a purpose as long as it's open to anybody in the church that wants to come. And we'd like to have new members.
Sure.
And some of them don't know how to play.
There's you welcome to come here now.
Well, I mean, I haven't been trying to advertise this group to them because I'm trying to advertise my own group,
sure.
which is the sing-along that's been meeting there for a long time. But it's a similar situation because there's only about two of us that are members of the Unitarian Church in that group, and everybody else is either a Quaker or a Methodist or doesn't go to any church. But they've been coming for a long time, so... You know, I don't think the church realizes how few Unitarians are actually going to the sing-along, but they wouldn't necessarily know about us either. You know, as long as it was open to the public, it seems like it could be handled similarly to the way that I'm handling the other group here. And there's pretty big classrooms that are sort of about this size, and they would have to rearrange them. Start out with and put a map, which is similar to what we're doing now. And it's in, and their Wi-Fi, I think they have a pretty good, decent Wi-Fi connection in every room. That was one of their goals, to get all that going. And I don't know if it fades off or anything, because my group doesn't use any technology at all, but other groups do. And it's nice to have a connection. So. Just something to think about, and
nice
I don't pay anything to church just because I'm a member. That's all I care about, you know, as long as it's open to the church members to go and have a good time playing with things.
I just have a fallback plan.
Yeah. If you have trouble with it, that's a great thing.
Okay. Thank you.
All right, yeah. What's your name?
Riley.
Right.
Yes, I'm just interested in music ourselves. And maybe getting a library together using.
Well,
like
yeah. Why don't you just call up today?
Matt, you can start.
I'm Mark.
Okay.
Mark. I always say Matt. Matt Mark.
I know, see? I'm not the only one.
I'm
I don't
Paul.
Always do that. I'm consistent.
Okay.
Okay.
Fancy?
Mary Jane.
Okay.
I'm Marty.
That's okay.
I'm Matt. He's Marky. I'm Matt.
That's right.
Don't let us mess with you. That's right.
Well,
I'm Charlie.
Yes, right.
Charlie, second from the top.
People online.
He's from
And I'm Walt. And I'm Walt. Still Brenda.
Still Brenda. And still Walter.
And if you'd like, you can...
Yeah. Yeah, this is a Zoom meeting. I don't know if you're using for other things, but...
You can go to our website and get a Zoom link if you're...
I don't have to do any of that. I'm so far behind the times.
Well, then, you're welcome to come here.
Yeah.
Been collecting since.
Let's do one of them right now.
Yeah.
Well, whatever you say.
Yeah.
How about this one?
Yeah. Yeah. Who's leading this one? Is that your song there, Jim?
Well, it's a song that I recommend.
Oh, for the group. Yeah, that's right. Okay.
But it's not live tonight. Yeah.
Did you say?
I think we're going to start a ride here too.
Oh, yeah.
Well, I'll add one of those while I'm at it.
Yeah.
So you're going to do that? You'll edit it? All right, great. Thank you.
I'm chained into it now.
Yeah.
You know, that's all you have to do. Just open my mouth.
I never mentioned things like
so
that.
So much the way it works.
Ah, nice song.
I'm going to do a little bit morning.
A straightforward song. I like that. I'm sorry I didn't give you credit for that in the email, but...
Let's see.
Can we see the chords
down? It's got a chord change in it on the third verse.
Oh, yeah. Well, let me add the chords.
Just
to
tell
it.
Me what an F sharp minor looks like.
It's your D chord?
That's...
And then drop your index finger down. Just one note change. I'm not sure how you do your D, but if you do it with your fingers.
There are the shapes.
The trouble is, remember to get down to that
key shape. Yes, there it is. Harry Stafford wrote it. The guy who wrote Suspicion.
Yeah, yeah.
He and his writing partner, Paul Fraser, I have no idea who that is, but it's on Harry Stafford's 1973. Album, but it didn't do very much. Got like a number 60 on the country charts, but
really?
It became a signature song for George Strait. It was like the second big single back in 1983. It really, it's become his signature song. And, it's nice. I like it.
Me too.
It's a great song.
He put a. George Strait put a little fiddle part on it that I try to imitate a little bit on the intro.
Intro?
Gotta see that G sharp minor again.
I just pulled the J minor up and then applied the G string.
Okay, I've done this one before. And as usual, I'm just bringing stuff back that I've done in the past. So are people familiar with this song?
Fortune teller?
No.
Went to the fortune teller, had my fortune read. Have you heard that one?
Oh, yeah, the Rolling Stones did it.
You can see up at the top. 1964. Yeah. It's one of their first hits. But it's actually a New Orleans song. It came from the Alan Toussaint. So basically, you just play those three chords over and over again, except there's one place every other verse it goes DC, DC. So, and then back to the DCA again.
All right. It says Alan Toussaint as Naomi Neville. He changed his name.
Yeah, you know, he made up that name to put out songs. He wrote so many songs in those years that he began kind of making up people to write them.
Okay,
that's
cool.
So here we go.
No, meet us. Hey, Walter, we can't hear you. Oh, yeah. Hey, Walter.
What?
You need to put on you need to turn on original sound.
And where is that?
Well,
I've seen you do this a million times, but I don't know where I do it.
It disappears when I go to sharing the screen. I can stop sharing, but then it's usually up in the upper left-hand corner on my machine, but it goes away when I start sharing.
I think Zoom intentionally hides its own stuff inside the screen, because it assumes what you're sharing is...
Well, is that on the on song menu?
No, it's the Zoom.
Where's that?
All right, let me, if I stop sharing, I guess you'll see it.
Let's try talking through.
Can you see the
microphone? Go to the microphone. I've got to make sure it's available. Right.
Yeah.
Where am I going? Oh, at the bottom.
Now, so you're seeing the just the Zoom only screen, and it's up here in the upper left hand corner. Can you see that?
Of your Zoom window.
Of your Zoom window, yeah.
Okay. I'm up here. There's nothing there.
He's not seeing yours.
Right. Well, he's not seeing.
Oh, that's right. I've got to go back to mine. How do I switch? Because I've got you guys on the screen right now.
Should be able to mouse up to the upper left, and it should appear.
Unless it's not enabled. That's the whole challenge.
Okay, let's start it this way. Do you see a microphone symbol in your lower left corner?
Yes, in the lower left.
There's a little carrot just to the side of that. Click that and you'll see a menu.
All right.
No.
I got the menu.
All right. You see one of them says something to the effect of audio.
Audio settings.
Audio settings.
Yeah.
Click that.
Okay.
Now, one of those settings somewhere in there is turn on original audio.
Original sound.
Original sound for musicians.
Resistance, yeah. It's about two-thirds of the way down the screen.
It's under audio profile.
Let's see. Zoom optimized audio. Audio, low, medium, high. Original. Wait a minute. Original sound? Is that what it is? Original sound.
You want to enable that.
You see a blue dot on it when you click on it?
Let's see. Yeah, got it on now.
All right, now. You're not through.
That's the first step.
You're not through. That's just allowing you to turn this feature on. So now you need to go in the upper left corner and look for something on the screen there where something about, what is it?
It says original sound for musicians.
Oh, I see it, yeah.
It probably says off.
You want to click that on.
It toggles back and forth when you click it.
Okay.
Does it say on now?
No, I can't get it to turn. Oh, there we go. I've got it on.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. Woo! Strum, right. Strum your ute for a minute. Let's see if we hear you. That's it.
Yeah, we got
much
it.
Better.
Hey, we can hear you now.
Okay, good.
I'll have a job at a call center.
Yeah, I don't want one of those.
I don't even want to get placed in it.
But thanks for the offer.
So we're ready? I feel muted. What's going on?
Oh,
we are muted. You're fine.
Oh, okay. So should I go ahead?
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, here we go. Fortune teller had my fortune read. I didn't know what to tell her. I had a dizzy feeling in my head. Then she took a look at my palm. She said, son, you feel kind of warm. She looked into a crystal ball and said, you're in love, love. How could that be so? I thought of all the girls I know. She said, when the next one arrives, you'll be looking into her eyes. I left there in a hurry, looking forward to my big surprise. The next day I discovered that the fortune teller told me a lie. I hurried back down to that woman, mad as I could be. I said I didn't see nobody. Why'd she make a fool out of me? Then something struck me, as if it came from up above. While looking at the fortune teller, I fell in love. Now I'm a happy fella, 'cause I'm married to the fortune teller. We're happy as we can be. Now I get my fortune told for free. Fortune told for free. And that's it.
Woo-hoo!
And now you know about your audio settings.
Yes, that was a good lesson. I've seen you do it in the meetings 12 times, and now I finally had to do it myself.
Yeah, if you don't have to do it, it's harder to learn it from somebody else doing it for you.
Right, right, right.
Next one up.
But that way it doesn't compress the sound and it looks like you're playing and singing in sync more.
Yeah. Well, I remember that from the meetings when I'm in the room there. How much better it sounds with the settings on.
Scottish song, but it does, it's the music is traditional, but the words were actually written by somebody, and I don't really know anything about the guy who wrote the song. So I'll just say it's a fairly easy.
Well, his mama
song.
Called it Gordon.
Yeah. W Gordon.
Yeah. W, get down here.
W Gordon.
Steel string, which was for years, and then once with the ukulele, I heard it. I bet I could do that again. That's what, yeah, it's what makes it
great.
Well, thanks. I might try it again.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Is this
also your song? Right?
Yeah, that's my song.
I'll come back to that.
Yeah, you wouldn't want to have to listen to me twice.
Oh. Okay.
Who's crashing the moon?
Yay!
Is that your song?
Yes.
Oh, all right.
Great.
I'm sure most people know this song, and it doesn't really have a tune, in a way.
My favorite kind of song.
You
know? Yeah, I've been coming up with songs like that lately. Tuneless songs. Just a few chords.
Okay, but you can talk along with it. Crash on the living room, water's gonna overflow.
I could sing a song, I guess.
Well, that'd be great.
I don't usually work for music, but you have an esteemed guest there that I want to dedicate this to. And I'm going to hang up my music here. And this is called Oh, I Want to Be a Dog. Oh, I want to be a dog. I want to wag my tail, chase cars and knock over garbage cans, fight the lady who rings the bell. Oh, I want to be a dog. I want to drool on the floor, get pats on the head, chase cats, get fed, chew your shoe, bark at the door. Oh, I want to have dog breath. I want to learn to growl, scratch fleas and ticks, chase after sticks. I want the moon to make me howl. Oh, I want to be a dog. I want the big, big holes. I want to sniff French poodles and basset hounds and be on telephone poles. Oh, I want to be a dog. I want a big wet nose. I want to run in the street, get mud on feet, and jump onto your clean clothes. Oh, I want to be a dog. I want to sleep on the ground. Being human these days is getting too crazy. I just want to be a hound. I guess he didn't want to sing along, but oh well.
Charlie, I was making a mental list of the things in that song that I haven't already done, and I'm very excited how short that list was.
Yeah. That was written by a guy up in Port Townsend named Jerry Canote, and he and his twin brother have a duo. His brother plays fiddle and Jerry plays guitar and ukulele, and Jerry's motto is play your ukulele daily.
There you go.
That's a good,
good
one.
Thing to say.
Is there any chance you could send me a copy of that song?
Well, there's a chance. I've only got hard copy. I'd have to scan it. And is there an email address I could send it to on the website?
Yeah, there's like a Tug Info email that you can send it to. I forgot.
Okay. Okay. Cool.
Take a picture of it with your phone. And
yeah, just take a picture with your phone. That'll be fine.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I'll do it when we're done here and get that on to you.
Great. Thank you.
Yeah. I don't play it that often by myself, and I'm not great on the melody, so you can just fake it, but like I did. There you go. Yeah. I wanted to ask Walter if he used to write for School Library Journal or Library Journal. I used to.
Yes.
Okay. You are Walter. All right. I used to. You used to work here in Oregon.
Yeah, I worked for Multnomah County Library.
Okay, a million years ago, probably, and then went away.
In 99? That's when I left.
Oh, okay. I thought it was longer ago than that. I saw you at a class in Portland State, probably in the late 70s or early 80s.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah. And to be honest with you, you used to play around. You'd do live performances with a little theater thing that you had on your shoulders and played ukulele. And
that was me, the puppets.
Yeah. But
Walter,
that was one of my inspirations for taking up ukulele. You had that little banjo uke that you played.
Amazing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's good to see you. Are you down in Texas?
I've been doing this for a long time.
Yeah. Are you down in Texas now, or where are you?
Austin. Yeah.
Okay. I'm hoping to get down there maybe in November. Maybe we can cross paths.
Yeah.
That'd be great. Yeah. Usually he's here in the big group.
Oh, okay. Well, are you guys there on Halloween?
If it's on a Tuesday.
Okay. Yeah, I believe it is. I think I'm flying in on Tuesday, and maybe I can make it there.
Cool. All right.
All right. Cool. Well, great.
That's amazing.
Yeah. Well, with a name like Charlie Johnson, there's a lot of us, but a name like Walter Kraft and Minkle kind of sticks in the mind.
Oh, that's great.
Did you have a song here?
Not really, because Paulette and I were going to do a song, but she's got a cold, so she bailed.
So.
Well, there you go. Cold, cold.
Who saw
that? That's my song too.
Oh, okay.
But if it's almost time to quit, right? What do you say?
We have it till 8:30.
Oh, okay. 8:30? I didn't know that.
Yeah. It's just that sometimes we don't have anything that left, and
yeah,
we
get
leave
there early. Get them all sung by 7:30, and then we're killing time for there.
Time for next year.
It's a balancing thing.
Everybody, who knows this song? Who knows it? Nobody?
Well, I know like a lot of Tom Waits. Tom Waits song.
I love Tom Waits. One time, I
the right voice, guys.
One time, me and a couple of friends on New Year's, we listened to Tom Waits all that evening. It was so cool because it was so just perfectly fit. You know what I mean? For a New Year's.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I smoked a few joints and then he walked in.
Yeah, right. There he was.
Big Joe and the Phantom 309.
That's right. What happens.
I get a couple of Tom Waits songs about 2 months ago or something like that.
What were they?
I get Big in Japan and Chocolate Jesus.
We'll play, Fancy.
Okay.
Crowds fall in sidekick in an old cafe. Never slept with a dream before he had to go away. There's a bell in the tower. Uncle Ray brought around. Don't worry about the army in the cold, cold ground. Cold, cold ground. The cold, cold ground. Cold, cold.
Great.
That's a good song.
Great song.
Song that the person Mary Chapin Carpenter did. We were going to do another Mary Chapin Carpenter song tonight, but I'm not going to attempt it without all that, but because I'd butcher it. But
oh no!
She did the song called Downtown Train, and that was one of his songs. And,
yeah,
she's got a great version of his song. She's got some great ones.
I think the Eagles did Old 55, which was one of his.
Another one? Okay.
Yeah, from what I understand, he hated it.
It was too clean.
Yeah. I like his version.
So who has Lily Marlene?
I have it, but wow.
Do you want to save it for?
You can do Mary Jane.
I'll save it. I'll save it.
That's right. You
did it a long time ago, and I didn't know that.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I love Lily.
So yours is The Devil Made Texas.
Yeah, The Devil Made Texas. And this is a song I've known for a long time, but I've never performed it. And that's because it's got so many verses, and you really have to sing them really fast. And I'm not a very fast singer, and I just thought I was going to gobbledygook the words if I tried to do it. But I finally said, it's about time to do it, because we've been doing these Texas songs about how awful it is to live in Texas. And this one really tops, well, I don't know if it tops them, but it certainly is up there with the best of them as far as making Texas look like, you know. It's called The Devil Made Texas.
Right.
And I do have a few kazoo parts. But I have to sing it faster than I am capable of singing. So this one required me to practice quite a bit too.
Documentary.
That's right.
I only stumbled once really badly.
No, it was great. It was great.
Yeah.
Don't say things like that. It
Very
was great.
Cool.
Well, we have come to the end.
Those other two songs aren't going to get
Oh, played. those were, one was the song that Paul I was doing, and I was thinking about doing it one by myself, but I think what I would rather do is play Amarillo by Morning again.
Oh, okay.
If you don't mind, Daniel, I really like that song, and it takes more than once going through it to
practice that G sharp minor. Highway to be found, leading
Really?
I was listening to that. Does that sound familiar?
Yeah, I don't
think it's in the movie.
I don't think it's in the movie.
No. Very nice, very nice. Well, shall we wander
Can you play an iReel Pro?
Oh, yeah.
I've been working on a song. It's not going to sound near as good as yours, but this one's driving me crazy, so I might as well make y'all suffer with you.
Get it out there.
Let's hear it.
Out
there. Dixie,
put it about 100 beats a minute, if you would.
No. Okay, 790. You wanted 100?
Yeah.
Oh. Daredevil. Tell me when you're ready. I've got this. I've got it set up so it counts twice because when I'm using it, I need to have two measures of counting.
Okay, go ahead and just do it like do. He does eight dots. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
But it's interesting. It's 2,000 hours of banjo.
Oh, wow.
And what it is, it's some guy that his wife gave him a banjo for Christmas, and he read on the internet somewhere that it takes 2,000 hours of practice to really get good. So he went from zero, and he's up to about 220 now. And he plays an hour a day, practices an hour a day, and he films himself every once in a while with it. It's just fascinating. So,
oh, that's kind of cool.
Now I need another few hours of this, and I'll come back.
All right. All right. Outstanding.
That's awesome. So how many hours have you put in so far?
On this one? It's amazing. There's a lot of notes in that song. Probably five, you know.
Well, you're getting there.
So,
anyway. So is this a song you're going to introduce to the Bluegrass Group?
I might. Larry's working on it.
Oh, yes.
It's an Eddie Collins, you know, set us up with it. So,
I wonder if I could get a copy of the music.
Talk to Larry. Yeah. He still has the guitar. So.
Yeah, okay.
Anyway.
Very nice.
Very good.
Oh, we're ready to do the...
Oh, the, well, we have to do Happy Trails.
Happy Trails.
It's not over until we sing it.
Yeah, Kevin wouldn't forgive us.
We do have
that's right.
Every night, every time.
The guy that was our leader and teacher and mentor and whatever else passed away. And he had just gotten us into playing Happy Trails at the end of each meeting. So we've kind of put this in our song. Continued that tradition.
I think I left the widow out to the monthly group.
Oh, you wait.
You might have?
Yeah, Karen.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's dating one of the other.
Yeah,
exactly. The John Davenport.
Yeah, the exactly. John Davenport. Yeah.
I can't say it without the
the
John Davenport.
Did you go to the Ohio State?
I don't know.
He said he had to do that because there was some other.
There's another John Davenport.
So he had to do it. I can't remember what it was. Something to do with his recording or something. But, so he's now the John Davenport. But anyway, yeah, that's a hopefully happy ending to a sad deal there. But anyway, okay.
To see everybody. I'll see you next week.
Later on.
Have a good week, everybody.
Good to see you
guys later.
Feel better, Walter. Get some rest.
We would have never figured out who Walter was if Walter didn't have his name on the screen tonight.
I know, it's amazing.
Yeah.
Like he showed up here on Halloween. Uh-huh.
That would have been great.
Which would have been fun in and of itself.
As a child, I played like an organ, you know, just being Luther.
Okay. Well,
just in an average kind of way.
Yeah, I bet you.
Thank you, Paul, for,
please have a little bit of
for making my
introduction.
Music.
You're very welcome. So, send me whatever you got. But
next time I'll.
Yeah. All right, thank you. If you're typing it up, that's the way to do it.
Are we supposed to put the chairs away? Or?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be great.
You're a new guest here, right?